fiery horse with the speed of light, a cloud of dust, and a hearty "Hi-yo, Silver!" The Lone Ranger.
Reached out to develop the vast resources of the Far West, decided to strike at the heart of the Barbary Coast. In an effort to stamp out the viciousness, Gearson sought for and found the Lone Ranger. This masked rider of mystery, though reluctant to leave the plains and mountains of the cattle country, answered the call and smashed the forces of evil in the Barbary Coast. His work in San Francisco finished, Tonto and the masked man headed north for the gold fields and the land of big timber. Return with us now to those thrilling days of yesteryear. From out of the past come the thundering hoofbeats of the great horse Silver. The Lone Ranger rides again.
On Silver! Faster, boy! Faster! On Silver! Away!
Gearson sat in his library. He'd read the Lone Ranger's letter twice and sat thinking about it as his mother entered.
Arnold, how long does it take you to read a letter? You said you'd be right out and play casino with me.
I'm sorry, Mother. I've been thinking about the things the Lone Ranger said. This letter came from him.
From the Lone Ranger? My sakes alive. What's he saying? Where is he?
Well, he's a long way north of here. He sent this by a man he met who was traveling south.
Is he still in the gold field?
No, he's in the lumber region by this time.
He is? What in town is he doing there?
Well, he thinks there's some trouble.
Oh, dear. I do hope he won't mix into trouble in a lumber camp.
Yeah, so do I.
In my younger days, I knew lumber camps. Your father was interested in lumber for a time.
Yes, I know.
I've known all kinds of lumbermen, from the general kingpin down to the swampers. They're a hard lot.
The Lone Ranger met a cook.
A hasher, eh? Hmm. What about him?
Well, he had to get out of the camp. The men got up and walked the table.
Mm-hmm. I've seen that happen, too. When the crew don't like the food they get up, the men walk up and down the length of the table, kicking off the dishes and the food. That means Cookie has to clear out in a hurry. Crummy doesn't like to have the dishes all smashed.
Crummy?
Also the bunkhouse with the grub dished out. Well, what's the Lone Ranger say?
Well, I'll read part of his letter to you, Mother.
Oh, go ahead.
Tonto and I were riding from the gold fields and heading south. We were going through a woods, and the dense underbrush and big trees made it slow travel. Scout and Silver had to pick their way. We heard a stream of water and thought we'd find it and rest a while. We didn't know there was a camp anywhere near until we came to a clearing. There was one man there. He leaped to his feet and raised his hands. He acted as though he expected to be shot on sight.
No, Oh, no, mister. Please don't shoot me. Don't do it. I won't make no trouble. All I ask is to be allowed to get away, that's all.
I'm not going to shoot you. Put your hands down.
That mask. You're an outlaw, a killer. Zeke sent you, I know that. But if you'll just let me go, you can tell him you killed me and he won't never know different.
Hey, big fella. Just a minute.
Please.
Don't be afraid of me. This mask doesn't mean I'm an outlaw.
Didn't you come from Cinnamon River?
No.
But you came from north of here.
Not as far north as Cinnamon River. That's up in the timber country.
I know it is.
How do I came from Placer City?
Tonto? Oh, your Indian friend.
Yes?
Me lead Silver. Take horses to stream. Let him drink.
Thanks, all right, Tonto.
Come, Silver. You can get water.
Then Zeke Vincent didn't send you to get me?
Well, I never heard of him.
I've been traveling night and day, getting away as fast as I could. I don't want no trouble. I ain't nothing but a hasher.
Hasher?
That's what the cook in a lumber camp is called. I'm a cookie and a darn good one. I never in my 15 years of cooking had the men walk the table till Zeke Vincent got him to do it. He wanted me fired.
Why?
He wanted me to get fired so I'd have to go away. He knew I'd be all alone in the big timber. Then he'd get a chance to kill me, none the wiser. Night and day I've been traveling. I got no bush tail and it ain't easy for a man my age to travel on foot.
What did you do to Zeke Vincent?
Not a blame thing.
Well, what's his job?
Zeke? He's been everything. He was a swamper and a four-up driver and a skidway man. Then for a long time he was a cruiser. But he got hurt and since then he's been a pencil pusher.
You mean he works in the office?
That's right. He got his leg hurt in the fall.
Maybe you're mistaken about him. He might have no intention of killing you.
I ain't mistaken. I know Zeke Vincent. He's a downright dangerous man. I'll never forget how mad he was. His nose was tight the day he found me asleep outside the office window. Thought he was going to run a knife into me.
That's because you were sleeping?
It wasn't because I was sleeping. It was because I was there, just outside the open window. He'd been talking to someone inside and thought I overheard what was said.
What was said?
I don't know. I swear to goodness, I don't know. He came out and saw me. Then he kicked me and started yelping that I'd been snooping on him. He raised a gosh-awful hullabaloo.
Who was he talking to?
I don't know. Didn't hear much of anything at all.
What did you hear?
I guess it wasn't anything at all. I told Zeke he didn't hear anything, but he wouldn't believe me. He tried to get me fired. Then when that didn't work, he got up and walked the table. The rest of the men followed him, and that done it. I was through. If it hadn't been that I traveled faster than Zeke could with that bum leg of his, I'd have been caught for sure.
Clem, you did hear something, didn't you?
No.
What did you hear?
That wasn't anything at all. Zeke told someone to give Hickory Jones one more chance. He said if Hickory didn't sell, he'd wish he had.
Who's Hickory Jones?
He owns a valuable stand of redwood on this side of Cinnamon River.
Cinnamon River? That's quite a distance north.
Yep. It divides Hickory Jones' land and the land of the lumber syndicate. Hickory is a hard man to deal with.
Is he cutting his timber?
No, and he won't let anyone else cut it.
Oh? Clem, Tom and I are going to camp here with you for a little while, if you don't mind.
Clem was willing for us to camp with him. I couldn't learn much more about Zeke Vincent or Hickory Jones, but I'm going to go north to Cinnamon Creek and investigate. Clem will take this letter to the nearest post office, Mr. Gearson. And by the time you read it, Tonto and I will be near Hickory Jones. This Hickory Jones land?
I think it is, Tonto. I think Cinnamon River is just beyond this forest. There's supposed to be an open valley on each side of the river.
Oh.
Thousand houses in that valley.
They smell smoke.
Smoke?
Not like forest fire. Smoke like camp. Small fire.
Tonto, look through there.
Oh, open valley.
There's a house. That's where the smoke's coming from. Hickory Jones' house.
Oh, that's good. We see him plenty soon, huh?
Nice, sir.
Oh, boy. Oh.
Get up. You're covered.
Covered,
then,
please.
Bring out the horses, Dirk. I got them covered. Come on, boy. of them's mask. Don't resist, mister. I've got the drop on you.
And me, too. What's the idea of the mask? We're not resisting.
This here is private timber, mister. Maybe you knew that when you came here.
I'm on my way to see Hickory Jones. This is his land, isn't it?
It is. And you're sure going to see Hickory Jones. Ride straight ahead. Go to the house and don't go fast. I ought to say we ain't lay a hand on anyone unless they try to resist.
Come on, Silver.
Get up, Scout. Get up. Get up.
This is Hickory Jones.
That's my name.
Where'd you get him, Jack?
He and the Redskin was coming out of the timber. On this side.
Where'd you come from?
The south.
All the way through my timber?
Yes.
I got guards on patrol on all sides of the timber. What'd you do to my guards?
We saw none until these two men stopped us.
You sure?
We saw no guards on the south edge of the timber.
I'll make them tell the truth, boss. Chances
Jack?
Are...
Jack! Huh? Shut up. The man is telling the truth. I know a lie and I know the truth. Maybe the guards missed you, but they shouldn't have. It's dangerous.
He told us he was coming here to speak to you, boss.
Not even to buy my timber.
No.
Tain't for sale and tain't for cutting. Is that clear?
Yes, quite clear.
I don't need the cash and I won't have those trees cut. I'm trying to get the government to take over this land and protect the Redwood Giants. Lumber and interest don't see eye to eye with me.
You hire guards to protect the trees you want to give to the government?
That's why I want the government to take them. I'd like to have someone else paying those guards. Costs money.
Yes, but I can't think of anything more worthwhile.
Why do you wear that mask?
Because that's used to conceal my face.
Well, straight enough answer to a straight question. You're coming here to see me?
Yes.
Why?
You know someone named Zeke Vincent?
Yes, he works for the syndicate in the big camp on the north of Cinnamon River. Friend of yours?
Oh, I don't know him.
He's bad, no good.
Has he tried to buy your land?
No one hadn't better. Throw him off.
Has anyone tried to buy it?
What is?
I met a cook from the syndicate camp. He overheard part of a conversation. One of the men who talked was Zeke Vincent. The other was unknown.
Man by the name of Danaher, Dude Danaher. I told him it wasn't for sale.
He wanted to buy it for the syndicate?
Yes and no. He said he was buying it for himself. He lied. He wasn't.
Did he make any threats?
He said there'd been a long dry spell. It was dangerous. Timber fire would clean me out. I'd do well to sell while I had the chance.
He meant that as a threat.
I know how he meant it. That's why I've got guards.
How much help do you have in case a fire started?
The men that work across the river would come and fight it. There'd be 100 men here in no time as fast as they get across the bridge. No good lumberman will let a fire go, even if it ain't his timber.
Do you want to ask me any more questions, Jones?
I'd like your name, but if you're masked, you wouldn't give it. Where are you going from here?
I want to find Danaher.
Jack, where did he go after leaving me?
Across the river. Probably with the men in the syndicate camp.
And that's where I'm going.
Now, look here.
Yes?
I didn't sell out, see? But there's men who have. Men who've had to sell out to that syndicate.
What happened if they refused?
Trouble. Sometimes one thing, sometimes another. Mules got poisoned and died. Flumes got smashed. Cable snapped. Machinery broke down. Trees fell wrong and hurt people. One thing after another to make the owner realize he'd be better off to sell.
To the syndicate?
To the syndicate. I'm glad you came here. You're needed bad.
What do you mean?
Boss, how do you mean he's needed?
Jack, you fool, this man's riding a white stallion, calls it silver. Came from south of here. He's just done some work in the gold fields. Before that was the Barbary Coast. This is the Lone Ranger.
A man we read about.
No, right or wrong.
I thought you suspected that.
Get this syndicate. It's bad. Get it, and you'll have the everlasting gratitude of every timber owner between here and the Canada border.
Curtain falls on the first act of our Lone Ranger story. Before the next exciting scenes, please permit us to pause for just a few moments.
Thank you.
to continue our story. The Lone Ranger and Tonto rode beside Cinnamon River, a turbulent stream both wide and deep, spanned by a bridge.
It isn't long since this river filled the whole valley, Tonto.
That right. That's why not many trees near water's head.
Well, they mean something else, too.
What's that?
Well, if Hickory's timber burned, it'd take a very high wind to jump the fire to the timber owned by the syndicate.
Heavy high wind.
The syndicate timber would be comparatively safe.
Ah. What we do when we get to syndicate camp?
I want to find Danaher, Zeke Vincent.
Oh. Bridge back of us now. We on syndicate land.
Yes. I can see part of the camp halfway up the side of that hill.
Otto, Rich, go up. Look at it. Other side blow up, too.
Big clear, falling like rain.
Come on, Silver. Come up. A blast at both ends of the bridge, two heavy timbers, heavy planks and rails high into the air. The masked men of Tonto were barely able to avoid the rain of massive sections of the heavy bridge. Then, when the last had fallen...
Otto, that man over there. He's running for the camp.
Come, he's him.
We want him.
Come on,
Silver. Let's count.
Rain up, or I'll rope you.
Get back or I shoot.
Rain up.
I'll kill you if you come here.
How about that kind of shooting? You're open.
I'll make the cost.
There. Hold to the hold up.
Let me go. Take this rope off me.
Over her back.
Let me go, you ornery murderer. The law will get you for this. You can't blow up bridges and get away with it.
The bridge I want to talk to you about. Come on. We're going to that lumber camp.
That suits me just fine. There's no place I'd sooner go. It'll be your word. The word of a masked man against Zeke Vincent.
The Lone Ranger took Zeke to camp and met the superintendent, Bill Barton.
I've been to my office, all three of you.
Me stay outside, watch horses.
That's right, Tonto.
I should be doing so.
My friend will guard the horses, Mr. Barton. Zeke Vincent and I will go inside with you. Go ahead, Vincent.
All right, come on. We'll settle this in a hurry.
Bill, that critter blew up the bridge over Cinnamon River.
We heard the explosion all the way up here.
Yeah, the mask fell.
Barton, I just crossed the bridge when I heard the blast. We would have been caught if we'd been a few seconds earlier, but the fuse had been an inch shorter.
You deny fixing the blast, huh?
Yes, of course I do. I saw that man riding away from the water's edge some distance upstream. I went after him.
Blame me, it broke my back by roping me.
Vincent has been with us a long time. I'd take his word against the masked man's.
I see.
You'll handle me against the mask.
Vincent, where is Danaher?
What? How'd you know about... I don't know anyone by that name.
He's the man you talked to when you discussed making Hickory Jones sell his land.
What's this, Zeke?
I don't know what he's talking about.
Barton, maybe you're in this, too. I don't know.
You know what?
Have you ever heard of a man called Danaher?
No.
He told Jones to beware of a fire if he refused to sell. Jones wasn't concerned about a fire because he knew all the men in this camp would be on hand to fight it. The bridge has been blown up. Now those men can't cross the river to fight a fire. You see, Zeke, I met old Clem.
What do you have to say about this, Zeke?
Chances are he told it straight. All but one thing. He's the one in cahoots with Danaher, not me.
Then why did I have to chase you after the blast?
I told you a minute ago to surrender your mask and gun.
I'll keep my gun.
No,
you won't.
Oh, my hand!
We're going to shoot.
I'm going to do more than that. I'm going to get the men together and tell them what's happened. You're too one-sided. All the laborers can't be that way.
Put down that gun.
Stand where you are.
Fire! Timber fire! Timber fire!
Fire and timber. Started already.
Where? What timber?
Far side of the river.
Otto, come with me. We're going to take a chance.
Uh-huh. You go. Come back here.
Come back here.
He's back of it, Bill. He's in cahoots with Schemer.
Give me that gun.
Come on.
That just left here destroyed the bridge.
Destroyed it? I seen it. He blowed it up. None of it to keep us from going to fight the fire. There's not a thing we can do about it.
Poor old Hickory Jones. His land is doomed. He'll be revenged. Boys, the masked man's trapped by the river. I'll pay $100 in cash to the man that brings him back here dead or alive. Keep the masked man.
Under that fire. Get him alive.
It's the masked man. Get him alive.
Hickory Jones had been telling Jack and Dirk about the Lone Ranger and his exploits.
Someone like that man's been needed around here for a long time. A mighty long time. He'll get to the bottom of things and do something about it.
Hickory, who do you think's behind the lumber syndicate?
It don't matter who's back of it. Chances are some big money man in San Francisco is a power behind the syndicate.
What can the Lone Ranger do about it?
Well, I don't know. What would you said he could do about the Barbary Coast?
I wouldn't have known where to start cleaning that place up.
The Lone Ranger did it.
Hey, Dirk. Open that door.
Better, Jack.
Open the door. Sounds like I smelled smoke.
Yeah, you got a wood pie in the kitchen.
That's more than that. I do smell it. It's strong.
All right, get it.
Boys, if that Danaher is done it, I'll get...
I saw him across the river yesterday.
There's a timber fire somewhere.
Here comes one of the guards riding like a fool.
It's our timber. It's the Redwoods. That's what it is. Dirk, get to the bridge. Take the best horse. Tell the men in the syndicate camp we got a fire here.
Oh, timber fire! It's deep in! Get fast! Ho!
Some of the boys are fighting, but we need more. We've got to cut and start a backfire. We need men.
Hurry, Jack. Get up! Come on. You come with me, Jack. We've got to fight as best we can till help comes.
Hickory and his men raced into the woods toward the ever-increasing smoke and presently saw the flames. Great giants were blazing, shooting flames as high as a man could see. The handful of men who worked for Hickory was a pitifully small and helpless group against so powerful an enemy as timber fire.
Head over there! Get that tree down! We've got to clear a path!
Why don't some of the others get here? They've had time enough.
Swing those blades! Get those trees down!
Hold it, boss. Stand clear. That big one's falling over.
Timber! You know you here. You can't get the trees down in time. Move back this way! Follow me! We've got to get a gap cut!
Where's Dirk and the syndicate men? Why don't they come?
The men fought suffocation and exhaustion. They struggled to drop trees and slow the fire until it could be brought under control. They fought a losing battle. Each minute it became more obvious that without help they couldn't go on. Danger increased. There was a chance that they might be trapped by the flames. But their love for fine trees gave them superhuman endurance. Hickory was everywhere, swinging a heavy axe with titanic blows.
Fight it! We won't quit! Fight it, boys!
Hair was singed, his face was black with soot, but on he fought with axe and saw, then...
Here's Dirk! Dirk, where are the others? Where are the boys from the camp? Are they coming?
Oh, Jack Hickory, they can't make it.
Can't make it? Why not?
The bridge is gone. Someone took the whole bridge down. There's no sign of it. The men can't cross the river.
They could swim?
They can't swim in that current. No man alive could cross that river at this time of the year.
Then take your horse out of here and come back. We'll fight this thing with what men we've got.
Get up!
In the meantime, the Lone Ranger and Tonto reached the bank of Cinnamon River.
Hold over, hold over, hold over,
hold
over. There's one chance for men to get across the river to fight that fire.
How that?
I'm going to cross with Silver and carry one end of a rope. Hurry, give me your rope.
Here.
Our two ropes tied together will reach.
There.
You hold one end.
Me, Clappy.
I add to your saddle. If any horse can cross this river, Silver's the one to do it.
Men, come this way. Come on, run.
They're after us. Tell them to grab the rope and pull themselves across the river.
Come on, Silver! You can make it. Come on, big fellow. In we go!
Struggling against the raging current, Silver fought toward the south shore while the lumberman came up on the run.
Stop! Come back here! You back your way!
Hey, you girl, that stream!
We'll get him if he don't!
You listen! Listen! Him not start fire! Him take rope to other shore! You grab rope, go fight fire.
Hey, is that what he's doing? He's carrying a rope.
Yes, here's the bag. Redskin's got one end of it.
He can't make it.
Look at that current sweeping him along.
Oh, boy.
Hey, listen here, Rich. Nick said the masked man blew up the bridge.
Sick lie. Why masked man risk life to help get you over water if him fella who blow up bridge?
He's making it. He's going to make it.
Go on, masked man. Get that rope over there so we can fight that fire.
Come on, masked man. We're for you.
He's made it.
He made it.
All right,
Tonto.
Brace the horse against the rope.
Up. Me ready.
Listen to me. Man inside the fire is somewhere in the forest. His name is Danaher. He's on Jones' side of the river. If you find him, hold him. Well, come on over here and fight the fire.
Oh!
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 I can hardly stand.
Yeah, me too, Hector. Come on, Lynn.
We can't give up. If you men want to quit, go ahead. I'll fight these flames till they lick me.
Two of Hickory's men had already fallen to the ground, unconscious from utter exhaustion. Those who remained fought doggedly, but the flames kept spreading with each passing moment. Hickory knew he was beaten, but he kept on with everything at his command. He felt himself grow weaker. The forest seemed to go in circles about him.
I gotta keep fighting.
His iron will kept him going a little longer. Then a great wave of giddiness assailed him.
He felt himself falling, and then...
All right, Hickory, I have you. Tonto, take him to your saddle. Get him out of here.
Got him fighting.
You've done your part. You kept the flames down enough so they can still be brought under control.
You, the Lone Ranger.
Our horses brought us ahead of the others.
The others?
Listen, 100 men from the syndicate camp are coming.
They can't cross the river. The bridge is...
They're across the river. They're here.
Cut that tree. You can pick up...
Axes.
The best woodsmen in the Redwood region. They'll save your timberland. They'll save it for the future generations to look at and marvel.
Tonto, the men come out of the forest?
Oh, me see now. Fire all over.
It was the Lone Ranger. He did it. I don't know how, but he got those men to me.
Him come now. Other fella come with him.
What about my men?
Jack, Dirk, and all other fellas sleep in bed. Them all right, only tired.
You.
Are you all right, Hickory?
You bet I'm all right. You saved the biggest trees in the world.
I want you to identify someone. Bring him in.
Get in there. All right, don't shove.
Danaher, you fire-setting skunk.
I'm not admitting a thing.
Some of the men found him in the timber. He was just about to start another fire.
I'll fix
it. Steady. Law will take care of him. Maybe when he gets through talking, we'll have Zeke Vincent to jail with him.
I guess we're stuck on this side till we can build another bridge, Hickory.
Men, I don't know how I can repay you for saving those trees.
We didn't save them for you. We saved them because we can't stand seeing fine trees burn. We'll deal with Danaher, and with Zeke Vincent, too.
That mash man. Hey, where'd he go?
Went outside to the engine.
Well, he's the Lone Ranger.
Just heard is a copyrighted feature of the Lone Ranger Incorporated.